Alright guys, so in these videos I'm going to be going through a much more rigorous explanation of how to calculate the major product for radical halogenation reaction. Now the reason that I'm even recording these videos is because your textbook goes through this more in-depth explanation, and I want to make sure that we have all our bases covered. Now understand that this might be beyond the scope of what many professors require for their students. So I'm going to leave it up to you to check with your professor to see if they want you to calculate these ratios or not. Alright, so let's just move right into the lesson. So everyone knows by now the general trend of radical stability, which is that tertiary radicals are more stable than secondaries, and secondaries are more stable than primaries. And that's been enough for us so far. We've been able to get by and just predict the major product that way. But if we want to calculate the exact percentages of major and minor products, we're going to need equations. We're going to need some kind of method, quantitative method, to do that. And it turns out that we can calculate that knowing the relative rate of halogenation at a certain temperature. So here you see this is a very important little table here. These are the relative rates of different types of halogenations at 25 degrees Celsius or room temperature. Let's just go through these numbers really quick so you understand what it's meaning, okay? So, remember how we discussed how chlorination is very unselective, kind of makes bad decisions everywhere, and bromination makes these awesome decisions? Well, this can be quantified, and the difference has to do with these halogenation rates. Notice that chlorination actually does prefer tertiaries, okay? So it's not, it has good intentions, okay? The problem is that it doesn't prefer tertiaries very much, only slightly. It likes to halogenate tertiaries about 5 times more than primaries, and only a little bit more than secondaries. So you can see how chlorination, you're going to get a lot of products everywhere, okay? Now if you look at bromination, bromination is much more selective, because bromination likes to brominate tertiary carbons 1,600 times more than primaries. So you can imagine that that's what we call bromination highly selective versus chlorination, which we basically call non-selective, okay? It has to do with the fact that the difference between the relative rates are much bigger when you get to bromination, okay? So here we can go back to our definitions and we can state that chlorination is non-selective because the difference between the relative rates is very small. Whereas bromination is highly selective because the difference between the relative rates is very large. Okay? Now these ratios that I'm giving you here are only valid at one temperature, and that's room temperature. Okay? Because that's the temperature that these experiments were conducted under. Okay? If we jack up the temperature for this reaction, the ratios between the different types of selectivity become, can you guess? Smaller, okay? Meaning that there's less difference between primary, secondary, tertiary. Why? The more heat you add to any reaction, the more ambient energy there's gonna be, so the less selective it's gonna be. It's gonna wind up, even bromination can be coerced into some bad decisions at a high enough temperature, okay? Awesome, it's getting hot in here. All right, so that's basically the concept behind this table, okay? Now, one note of caution for you guys, you might be flipping through your textbook and you might see slightly different values here. Like you might see it says 1 and then 4.2 and 5.5. I don't really care about the details. The reason I chose these numbers is because these are the safest, roundest numbers that I could find from a combination of sources. I looked online, I looked through a few different textbooks, and these numbers just seem to make the most sense. There's no point in teaching you with complicated numbers. But in general, the ranges are correct. It's 145, about there, and then about 180, 1600, okay? If your professor teaches you different values, by all means, do not argue with him. Just go with his values. Everything that I'm saying is still going to pertain to that, even if you have to use different values.